gentlemen. I just got this handed to me. A hit-and-run felony at Ray's Cafe, 208 North Los Angeles. Got a patrolman on site. The coroner's on his way. Get down there. See if you can find any witnesses who can put a make on the car.
Straight through the red light. Said she never saw it.
Hey, you think those Vice boys get any on the side?
I have no idea.
Oh, Susie, you are so bad.
Hey, aren't you supposed to be on Mad Men? Ah, oh well. Oh, wait for me, partner.
Need a drink. I got the jitters again.
Well, the drink isn't going to really help you with that. You keep drinking, you'll get more jitters. Different kind, though.
It's him! The cop from the newspapers!
Oh, I can exit through here.
I don't want to be rude, but I ain't got
that's handy. Alright, so let's just quickly go down our case objectives right now. Investigate Ray's Cafe. Pretty easy. Hit and run with one fatality. Examine the body. Need a witness for the car. We can't really do much, so let's just get there and find things out. We'll drive there once again, just in case we might get some sort of random happenstance. Let's practice our driving, shall we?
Looks like the DA is going to press charges. Anna Rodriguez might do time.
I'll speak to the DA. She suffered.
I don't know, Cole. She's an easy make, and the DA likes to fix her.
I'll convince him to let me go.
He has a heart of steel. I mean,
I'll give him something better.
Heart of gold. I go through this little alleyway. Okay, I may. What? Oh god. Alright, don't say anything, partner. I'm not lost. Aha. Whoops. Okay, don't worry about the whiplash. He'll be fine. You'll get it covered, I'm sure. Oh! Crazy drivers. Here we go. 4:35. I need coffee. Yikes.
Detectives, over here.
What? Why am I moving? There we go. I think my button got stuck. What's up?
Cole Phelps, traffic. What have we got?
Vic is a white male named Lester Patterson. Walked out of the bar and into the street. Car hit over there and he ended up here. Dead on impact by the look of it.
Have you canvassed the area?
The only one with anything useful to contribute is the young lady over there. She lives above the bar. Name is Shannon Perry. No, it's not a stage name. 24 years old, she left Kansas to follow the yellow brick road.
Is that so?
We'll take a formal statement later. Right now, we're going to take a look around.
All right. Look around time. Well, check out his hat. Anything interesting about the hat? No? Can I move it around anywhere else other than back and forth? Up and down, maybe? No? Alright, I guess it's just his hat. Fair enough.
Phelps, you should take a look at the body. The poor guy didn't stand a chance.
What do you mean?
Oh. I made a preliminary examination.
Okay.
Probably want to take a look, then we'll talk.
Okay.
Landed on his face and ended up here. The car must have struck him from behind.
Jacket pocket. Always check the jacket pocket. I've learned this now. California Fire and Life. It's with great pleasure that we acknowledge the receipt of your application 14F, and pre-approval has been granted to raise the weekly premium of your life insurance policy from $370 a week to $590 per week.
Life insurance.
Where our standard veteran care policy entitled you to a lump sum of $10,000 in the event of your untimely death or permanent incapacitation. $16,000, in which someone wasn't very happy to hear about that. Huh. Okay. Oh, man. Alright, what else we got? The arms? Anything interesting about your hands? I don't think so. There we go. Alright, well, how about... Oh, the other jacket pocket. Aha!
We can notify next of kin.
Yikes. That's... tragic. What we got here? Just some money? Okay. Anything else? Don't think so. Alright, how about your head? Oh man, you look like you've seen better days, dude. And finally, this hand. Huh. That's interesting. Maybe it's just a coincidence, but that almost looks like where a ring should be. I don't know if that got knocked off. Alright.
What have you got on the victim?
From all reports, he was intoxicated at the time of the accident. I don't know how intoxicated once I'd done the autopsy. Looking him over now, I'd say he died on impact.
What about the chest wound? Isn't that inconsistent?
Very common in auto injuries. Look for a car with a prominent hood ornament. Those things are killers.
Prominent hood ornament. Interesting. What we got here?
Body traveled a good 20 feet.
Jeez. Anything else other than that? Not really. Alright, what else we got here?
This blood is a long way from the body. The car must have been going like a bat out of hell. So the driver managed to brake before the impact.
But he didn't brake fast enough. Or he was going so fast the brakes didn't matter and still hit him hard enough to kill him. Instantly on impact. That's not good. Got anything else?
Sorry, Phelps. Do you mind if I get on with this?
Alright, fine. Be that way. That's all the evidence I can come up with right now. What's my intuition at? I got 4. I should be alright. Bothers me that I don't see anything with this hat, though. I'm gonna just give one last look around. Because I'm just that neurotic. Woo! Alright, enough of that. Well, that's about it.
I'll have some prints ready for your report if you let me get on with this.
Jeez, alright. How about you, Chief?
Any ideas?
Witness statements next. We know we've got the girl as an eyeball, but we should check the bar as well.
Okay. Can do.
It's all yours, Detective.
Press I to use intuition to search for clues. Okay, I know, but I... Is that a hint? Oh, what the heck, I'll use it. Why not? Oh, I see. Oh, there's more inside. Okay, well, let's do that then. Oh, it's a newspaper? That doesn't count. Sh- Shrink to the Stars promises mental press. Oh.
Courtney, come in. Have a seat.
Thanks.
How are you finding working at the clinic?
It's, fine.
Are you sure?
Can I be honest with you, Doctor?
I would hope so, Courtney.
I was hoping that the therapy would be more beneficial.
Treatment can, unfortunately, be very long-term.
So many of the patients here are addicts, Doctor.
Many of them have been for years, Courtney. In the past, these people were condemned to sanatoriums. We can reveal the root of the problem, then we have a chance to help.
And until then, they stay sedated?
Do I detect a hint of reproach, Courtney?
I was expecting more, Doctor. I'm sorry. I don't mean to criticize.
Part of being a physician, Courtney, learning to be patient.
How is it possible to keep so many of them on their medications, Doctor? Many of their addictions are illegal.
Oh, many things in life are gray, Courtney. What may on the surface appear to be illegal is actually of benefit to society at large.
Oh, dear. All right, well, that had nothing to do with the case, but that was still interesting. And I still have... Oh, maybe it's on the outside.
I'll take the bartender. You work the rest of the room.
No, not yet. Oh. That's important. Like, a bloody frickin' knife. Oh. Oh.
A knife covered in blood. Could be a steak knife. This is a hit-and-run case, Phelps. Anyone could have thrown away a kitchen knife. In any case, we'll want tech services to scrub the alleyway before they bag the knife.
All right, I guess the intuition was worth it. I would probably not have caught that. That is extremely interesting. All right. Witness time.
Miss Perry?
Yes?
I'm Detective Phelps. This is my partner, Detective Bukowski. Can you tell us what happened?
Well, I came to the window because I heard people arguing downstairs.
Seems fine to me.
Then what happened?
I saw a car hit that poor man and knock him down the street.
What kind of car was it?
A dark red Lincoln Continental.
Okay.
Did you see the license plate?
Only the first three letters, I'm afraid. 3C8.
All right.
Tell me more about the argument you heard.
Well... there were two voices. Man and a woman. That's all.
Why are you holding out on us, Miss Perry?
I'm sorry. I was hoping to tell my story to the newspapers. I'd like to get my picture in the paper. Trying to find work as an actress, and things look pretty difficult.
Cough it up, sister. We don't have all night.
People arguing? They were husband and wife. I could tell by what she was yelling. Intimate things. Very embarrassing for the man.
Thank you, Miss Perry. Your information has been very helpful. You can go now.
You really think so? I hope you find that driver and put him away.
Yeah, here's the problem. I think...
you certainly got away with the dames, Phelps.
Heck yeah, I do.
Give it a rest, Bukowski. Let's see what the patrons have to say. I'm Detective Phelps of the LAPD.
How can I help, Detective?
Your name would be a good start.
Dudley Lynch. Hired help. I run the place when the owner ain't around.
Where is the owner?
He stepped out. Somebody had to take Lorna, Mrs. Patterson, home.
Huh. All right. Seems to be a little... bucking me a little bit, but let's just start with the top.
What can you tell me about the accident?
Not a lot. It was busy in here, and all I heard was the impact.
Uh-huh.
So what was he doing outside? It's against licensing regulations to drink on the sidewalk.
Esther and Lorna were having a fight. The owner made him take it outside. It was pretty ugly.
Okay. I want to know about this argument.
A witness overheard an argument.
Lester and Lorna. There's nothing like airing your dirty laundry in public, is there?
Keeps looking away.
Why was Lorna Patterson in such a hurry to leave? What is going on here?
Lorna was pretty upset, so Leroy took her home. Lorna and Leroy are close. They've been talking about opening a new bar.
Leroy.
Leroy Sabo, the owner.
Do you know the victim?
Yeah, Lester Patterson. He's a regular here, or he was.
Fair enough.
Not one of your favorite customers?
Lester was special, but not my kind of special.
Was Lester drinking alone?
No. He came here with his wife. She didn't seem too interested in the booze, though.
How long have Lorna and Leroy been talking about this new bar?
Who knows? I just served the drinks.
Bartenders hear all sorts of things. Are you gonna tell me, or do we have to start playing rough?
When Lester was drinking, he treated Lorna like dirt. He gambled away all their money. Lorna pitched Leroy about the bar. I don't know how interested he is.
Is Leroy doing well?
Hell no. The only thing keeping this place afloat are the poker games.
Thanks for your help, Lynch. I'm gonna need you to sign a statement with the patrolman.
Sure, no problem.
You get anything out of the regulars?
They weren't giving too much away. They liked watching Lester and Lorna go a few rounds every other day. And Lester was a fan of the love tap.
Oh, great. Awesome. Abusive husband, life insurance policy, husband and wife arguing, the owner of this bar needing some money to get things started. Seeing where this is going. Oh boy, am I ever seeing where this is going. Alright, let's give ourselves a little call, shall we? Let's see exactly where this is going.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need to run a partial license plate, 3 Charles 8. Cross-check possible Lincoln owners. Suspect vehicle is a red Lincoln Continental.
Just a moment, Detective. Only one possible make on that license. Registered to a William Shelton, 738 West Temple Street.
Thanks for your help. Looks like we caught a break on this one.
Yeah, there's more to this, though. There's much, much more to this. Let's just go to our objectives now. Did I get any more intuition? Oh, I did. Alright, that was worth it. Alright. Alright, the next is the Shelton residence. Easy enough. Alright, let's split. Bloody kitchen knife. Jeez Louise. Actually, let's go over our evidence real quick. This bloody knife. Starbright stainless steel kitchen knife. And it's stained with blood. Insurance letter, too. It's pointing us a picture, ain't it? Alright. As long as they don't mess it up on the interviews, we should be okay. Now, where's my car? I think that's ours across the way.
Careful where you step, Phelps.
Oh, sorry.
I don't come down to the station house and tap dance on your desk.
Whoops. Sorry. Still kind of new at this whole detective thing. All right, well, we'll drive to that residence, too. I'm curious about these little, you know, random happenings.